indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Commissioner Duckett.
Here.
Rivet. Bernie.
Here.
Brunner. Hilliker.
Here.
Gerard.
Present.
Kuzetsky.
Present.
Lewis.
Here.
Morris.
Here.
Madam Mayor.
Present. Is there a motion to excuse Commissioner?
Thank you. Move to excuse Commissioner Rivet and Commissioner Brunner. Commissioner Rivet is on his way. Commissioner Brunner, let me know what you really want.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Seeing none, they are excused and they are not. The first item tonight is a closed session with MMRMA Attorney Grant to discuss Denisha Villan versus the City of Mason. We will have another closed session, and that is a closed session with the city staff regarding collective bargaining agreement with Teamsters Local 214 Supervisory Commission Director.
Yes, move to go into closed sessions for both MMRMA Attorney Timothy Grant for Sheena Villan versus City of Bay City, and closed session for city staff regarding collective bargaining agreement with Teamsters Local 214 Supervisory.
Thank you. Is there a second, Commissioner Duckett?
Thank you, second.
Is there any discussion?
Commissioner Duckett?
Yes.
Rivet?
Yeah.
Bernie?
Yes.
Hilliker?
Yes.
Gerard?
Yes.
Kuzetsky?
Yes.
Clements?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Yes.
I
And they bring some of those.
Yeah, I had to do it.
December 13th.
did it that way, that makes sense. They don't do that now.
The only way to deal with this is you're going to dig them up. I mean, you go back all the way.
One person ever shifted draft.
And they also, like, you wanted them, they.
Yes.
Definitely, like, when you took those drinks from the. They just.
Because it's not in session.
No, that was the one. And the one thing the consumer wasn't around in the area.
So, because it's somebody else. So always get the kid, depends on who's there and which clerk it is. She is the one who does the most, because she's. But there's one really. There's one facing us.
I hate to see what the inside, that's another.
I see the one from the one shop, so I don't know. I don't know if the other one's.
So it looks like they could put one of each.
All the other part of it is actually done.
Because it's just, look, it's a control panel, we don't have someone doing the IT.
What you miss at home when you watch these is they're all their non-verbal stuff.
Because
tons of.
Plus those.
And it still wasn't tight.
Those mics have to be very small.
Yes.
So I think of more on that than I do on anyone else.
In the spring.
Yeah. I can hear it. It's right away. It's supposed to
go down into the root system and kill it.
Yeah, it's not technically supposed to kill it.
If I had money, I'd get one of those.
It's gross.
Sure, ones that are.
So I guess maybe you have.
And she reaches, those pick up the A's. But.
So the app.
Here. We're about 10 months worth of our hands.
But is it on our own?
Oh,
I have no idea.
I
remember, so I was sitting here and I'm thinking, did that, did she
buy that? I was going to say, you not only did that in the Gap people. Jimmy Gordy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Although now that you pointed that out, I've
There was something that was coming in.
A lot of stuff.
So it was on the one online and not the one.
It was on the one online. It was on the first one.
Charging it. Not much longer.
So tonight we have a presentation on Uptown. Commissioner Bernie had asked about a month ago on the project, kind of the background of the project for Uptown. So Sarah and Shelley are going to do just a really short synopsis of the project.
So you can see we've gone from a taxable value of $519,000 up to restaurants. This has created new customers for local businesses, of course, new utility customers for the city. It is quite honestly the largest development for the city today. We have received a couple of awards for the project. The more outstanding ones are the 2015 EPA Outstanding Contributions to Site Development Award and the 2019 Michigan Municipal League's Community Excellent Award. So we're very proud of the project. It's something that we do a lot of work on every year. It's a project that continues to keep going. Right now, the developer teams have entered a bit of a pause with construction. So you'll see that there's probably not completed construction here for a little bit. They're working on several other projects in other communities right now. But certainly they have not been in sight. There will be more buildings coming. Just there's going to be a pause for a little while. So, and I think with that, I think that was our last slide. And so we'll take any questions. It was kind of short and sweet to the point, but I was hoping that we hit on the high points.
Thank you. Yes, I asked for this, so I appreciate the presentation. Quick question. So, and maybe on the expense side, right, that's the question. So, do you have information? So, $16 million collected, how much has the city spent then on the project or the cost for bonding and whatnot?
So, the bonding was authorized by the Brownfield Development Authority, and those bonds are paid for out of tax increment. So to date, we are, let's see here, we have spent about $9.2 million repaying debt. And that includes a $1 million loan for people. And so we have about, let's see here, we have about $400,000 left on our people loan. And then we have about $32 million left on the bond debt. Because once you add all the interest, so the bond that would be paid off in 2042, which is when Brownfield Plan ends this project. And there's sufficient tax collection to not only pay that bond, but it could have sense very much so we have at least two times that we're
so once that bond that's paid, so theoretically then those resources that we're collecting taxable dollars go back into the city coffers, general fund, correct?
When the Brownfield Plan the full amount of the value of the property and goes back to all the tax institutions.
Okay. So a lot of people see a lot of improvements that are done on a regular basis. Is that part of the brownfield where some of the dollars are collected? Is there an allocable amount annually that they have to spend on that area? Or is that done privately by the Shaheens?
So it depends on which improvements you're speaking of.
So you know, there's a lot of folks, you know, the maintenance folks that take care of the planting. There's a lot of, is that privately done or is that through a reimbursement?
That is privately done.
Okay.
She needs to take care of that process.
Okay. No, that's good to know because there's been a lot of questions about that. Who's paying for that and how's that funded? Okay. Thank you. That's all I have.
Thank you. Commissioner Burley?
I did
that ask to have you come here for a presentation for Uptown. I never asked you for that. I asked you for my third ward, the economic development monies and funding, what you were gonna do for the third ward. I wanted that presentation on, I'm gonna read it to you. When emailing, this was on this night.
Commissioner Burley, this isn't germane to
I mean, it is to Sarah Dental. I requested to talk to have Sarah Dental on August 9th to come here and to talk to me about the economic development monies. Now, what this young lady is talking about, if you flip it around, that's what I'm talking about, the money that was supposed to be spent in the third ward. That's what I wanted to hear.
But I wanted to hear that economic development was supposed to be done for the third ward. So I'm going to read it right here, what you were supposed to be talking about. Same thing. When emailing on Tuesday, I will not be undermining Commissioner Doggett. The meeting was not as set for a personal issue. The meeting was not set up because we needed to talk to the city manager, Sarah Dimitrov, and I was told you were not going to be available to talk to me about the economic development for the third ward. Why was that, and why are we talking about the Brownsfield monies that were supposed to be spent for the third ward?
Commissioner Bernie, if I could shed some light on why they are here speaking. A couple meetings ago, you did mention about you were making reference to Uptown and their tax dollars on where they were going. And Commissioner Girard asked at that point to have a presentation on that exact same thing that they just described. So if you want us to do a presentation on the third ward on economic development, I guess I need more clarification on what dollars you're talking that needed to be spent in the third ward, just so we are prepared to make that presentation to you.
The same dollars that they spent for Uptown, I asked her to come here August 9th, the same way she's standing here and talking, I would have liked her August 9th to do that same presentation. There's not a difference. Why didn't she do this August 9th instead of for Uptown for the Columbus Business District? Yes.
Thank you. So I know that we have 18 years left on the bonds, but were they refinanced during COVID for lower rates, or was there an opportunity to do that?
Yes, there was. A portion of the bonds were refinanced. So right now the bonds are sitting, we had four issuances. One issuance just got paid off, so now we have three. And they're sitting anywhere between 2% and 4% variable.
Do you remember off the top of your head what they were before?
I know we only refinanced one issuance because refinancing the other ones might be not advantageous once we added all the bond financing costs, but we did refinance one issuance.
They went down. That's what matters.
This is, yes, they did. It was very favorable.
I'm also
thinking.
We're capturing the whole 16 million, right?
No, there's still a portion of the base that goes out to the tax jurisdictions.
519
now. It's relatively small, but there is still a portion of the base that goes out to the tax jurisdiction that we can't match.
Are we capturing the school tax?
Yes.
So the 16 million you're talking about, that just is going to pay for the development until 2042. So we're only seeing about $30,000 a year in taxes for schools and everything from now until 42.
Not all of that is not reimbursed to developer. Part of that, we had some interim costs that we've been reimbursed for as well, but a large portion of it does go to that.
Seeing no one, thank you very much for the presentation. Next order of business is the adoption of the agenda. Do any members of the commission wish to add an item to the agenda? Seeing no one, is there a motion to adopt the agenda? Commissioner Dockett?
Thank you. Move to adopt the agenda.
Is there a second? Commissioner Girard?
Second.
The clerk, please call the roll on the motion to approve the adoption of the agenda.
Commissioner Brady?
Yes.
Hilliker?
Yes.
Gerard?
Yes.
Wenzetsky?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Dockett?
Yes.
Bremen?
Yes.
Hey, yes.
The motion is approved. The next order of business is the consent agenda. Do any members of the commission wish to make a change in the consent agenda? And if you do, please give me the item number and their description. Seeing no one come forward, the next order of business calls for public input on the consent agenda. This is the opportunity for citizens to remove an item from consent for consideration on the regular agenda. If anyone in the audience wishes to make a change, please come to the microphone, sign your registration sheet, state your name and address for the record, and the item that you wish to have considered. Lori, 505 East Memory Street. Number 7. Which is the Military Management Board meeting minutes. We'll put that in the regular agenda. Do I speak now in regards to it? Thank you. Thank you. Is there anyone else? Seeing no one else, is there a motion on the consent agenda? Commissioner Dockett?
Thank you. Move to approve the consent agenda.
Is there a second? Commissioner Morris?
Second.
The clerk is called for all the adoption of the consent agenda.
Commissioner Hilliker?
Yes.
Gerard?
Yes.
Wenzetsky?
Yes.
Clements?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Dockett?
Yes.
Rivet?
No.
Ready?
No.
6-0.
The motion is approved. The next order of business is remarks of the mayor and the commission. At this time, I would just like to thank everyone that participated in the Christmas tree lighting, especially Sue Gorczak, who donated a beautiful tree that stands. It's actually bigger than the White House and the New York City tree. It's taller, and I believe it's rounder. And Commissioner Dockett did the reading. I heard it was very good. I watched it on my phone. So, and then Midland Street had some things going this weekend. I don't know if either one of the commissioners want to speak on that during commission time. You can. And I guess that's about it. We do have to remember that I need your houses and businesses if you have a business in your ward, so I can go and judge for that contest. And that's coming up sooner than you think. Thank you. Any Commissioner Gerard?
Thank you. I did have the city manager. In front of you talking about projects that are upcoming, projects that are current, gives you a nice kind of breakdown of what's been going on with infrastructure. One of the topics, however, that I've been kind of talking about is how do we address our local neighborhood streets, and so that's a challenging issue. We've done a fairly decent job of getting in grant dollars and utilization of some reimbursements of ARPA dollars to do a lot of projects. Probably the most I remember in a long time, the last couple of years, we spent more money collectively. So, which is great, but you know, people really want to see it in their neighborhood. So that as a group, I think we have to figure that out, how those resources can come in, either outside resources or we have to brainstorm. I know hits them harder when we have to do these kind of things. So we really have to be figuring out here on how do we make our community attractive for younger people to stay, to raise their families here, so that, you know, when they have kids and their kids stay here. We just had a lot of folks leaving the area, and what happens, they're growing up elsewhere, and they don't come back. We've had folks that do come back, and basically it's a great place to live. I feel like I came back, I know others have, but we really have to think about it and all our decisions on how do we grow the community. I think we slow the process of decline, you know, looking at some of the numbers, but really to reverse some of these trends, we have to grow. So that's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Commissioner Yachivinsky?
Get closer. I just wanted to touch on the December Dasbury event that the Lincoln Street Manager toured, and so many of our businesses helped put on this last weekend. It was great that we had a great collaboration both between city staff and the management board to pull it off. And what was neat to see was city and county commission collaboration. I mean, Ed and Colleen really came through with donations and a lot of support. So I think everyone who participated. I don't think it would have happened without Joel Tacey. He came up with the idea last minute, and we just started to roll with it. He was there for support, and arranging, you know, Santa visits and things like that, getting the posters out. So just to everybody who participated, it was a great weekend. We had a nice group picture Friday night under the lights. Commissioner Bernie showed up to represent the East Side, so we were very grateful for that. That was a nice surprise. And so far, I have two more businesses who wasn't able to make it today for donation pickup, but as of right now, we have $262 donated for the Santa House among 26 donors. So I think for the first year and not a lot of preparation, that was pretty impressive.
Thank you. Commissioner Bernie.
Yes, I have something that I was thinking about, the safety of Bay City. I was wondering, do we have any money in our budget that we could help out the county, Bay County, like the fire department, just things for safety? There was a stabbing, some girl got stabbed 8 times just recently, and we need, you know, we need the fire department, we need, like the hospital, we need more nursing. I was talking to a young lady that was saying that they're overwhelmed. And so I'm wondering, do we have any money in the budget that we can help with the fire department? They really, how can I put it? The police, the public safety, they need to be public safety. The firemen, they need to be firemen. We just need that. And the county, they, especially the jail,
I know,
they need an upgrade. The police department, they need their own police department. So with that being said, it would be nice to help them out with the county. So I'd like to see that for them.
Thank you. Commissioner Rivera.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I vote no on the consent agenda because I think it's just being too expansive. Right? We voted on a union contract tonight. I think that should be a record roll call. We addressed a circumstance related to First Amendment rights without any real conversation or discussion. I think that should be, in fact, a agenda item where we can actually put a vote up and demonstrate that we're, in the light of day, addressing issues. And, you know, maybe it speaks to a broader issue of communication and daylight or transparency. So, wonderful presentation today. We saw $16 million in taxes generated by Uptown. What wasn't mentioned is most of that $16 million actually has never touched the taxing authorities. The school didn't see it. The county doesn't see it. We don't see it, right? And so I'm interested in daylighting information that exists in the city because I just think we're taking consent agendas that don't demonstrate, you know, the real work, some of the hard things that people should be aware of. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Thank you. Commissioner Kubas.
Just for point of clarification for the second ward, Commissioner. So you do have the opportunity to pull any item from the agenda that we can discuss in the debate. Just for clarification, you can do that so we can have it. It doesn't have to be on consent. It can be voted on individually. So just so you know, thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Rimmer.
You know, Commissioner, all through my esteemed colleague from the 6th, I spend a lot of time presenting information contrary to the flow of city operation and business. And you know, at some point you tire of that, right? And perhaps we can take a new approach as a government, change a culture, and try and make as much information readily available in real life folks and as possible, right? I just don't, I think there's ways to, you know, I would be one, I'm 100% supportive of the uptown development, but it's fair that the people know that the tax dollars won't come in until 2042, right? I'm 100%, I think that's how you have to move business moving forward. But you start with, listen, we're not gonna see any real tax increases until 2042. And that's the approach that I think cultural change we can make to better daylight our business to the people of the city.
Thank you. Commissioner Dockin had his hand up before you, Commissioner Torres.
Thank you. With regard to uptown, there's an old proverb that society prospers when old men plant trees whose shade they will never see. I think uptown is one of those cases where we don't benefit from it right now. We won't benefit from it next election cycle. We won't benefit from it in 3 or 4 election cycles. But eventually, those buildings and those properties will fall on the tax rolls. They will benefit the schools. They will benefit the county. They will benefit the parks and the police department and the fire department and all the other things. Some money in the future is better than zero money in the future. And it's still better than zero money today. So, I really don't understand why that's an issue. On the other side of things, with regards to pulling items off the agenda, obviously everybody's free to do that, but we're at a meeting, we vote on it. We can vote on it individually, or we can vote on it as part of consent, but at the end of the day, we still voted on it, and people have the opportunity to come here and pull it, we have the opportunity to pull it. I don't understand why it's an issue. It's 6 in 1, half a dozen of the other, because we still voted on it on the same day, roughly at the same time, if we just have everything individual on the agenda. I understand that there are different ways of doing things, and I appreciate that, but I think the way that we do this is fine, and I understand that there's differences of opinions on that, but this may be different than what people are familiar with. But different doesn't necessarily mean bad. It just means different. And sometimes different does mean bad, and sometimes it means better. And I can't wrap my head around why it's bad to vote on things or vote on things versus vote on things, I guess. I struggle with that. So this is what nitpicking. That's all I have. I'm just confused more than anything. Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Gerard.
I'm all set, thank you.
Commissioner Byrne?
Yeah, big question. Do we have a fire station and a police station that are going to be together out in the county here? Are they going to be in the same building? Are they teaming up together, public safety and a fire department? That's what I was wondering. In 2024, are they going to be together in one building?
Fire department and the police department work together now. Our firefighters, our police officers, so they go on call. But as far as being together in a building,
yeah, I was wondering, like out in Bangor Township, I was someone asked me that. I wanted to clarify to see, are they going to be in the same building?
They
they will never be located outside of our city limits.
Okay, are we going to get the police department their own building, their own, instead of being with the county? Public safety, are we gonna eventually get them their own building?
Yes, we are looking to do that, yes, down the road.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Anybody else? The next item is manager report.
Commissioner Gerard covered the engineering report. We discussed this in our meeting. Chris thought this would be, Commissioner Gerard thought this would be a good report for commissioners to have to show your constituents what projects have been done over the past year and projects that are upcoming. We can show where their tax dollars are going, which is a great report. And Commissioner Gerard had also mentioned that we have a speaker coming. We're really excited to have John Lamacchia from MML coming. He is our state and federal government affairs team leader, very good at what he does, and he's going to talk to commissioners and city staff when he comes to our infrastructure meeting. Also, I had placed conflict of interest forms at your seats last meeting. I only have four of them returned. If you need an extra one, I do have them here for you tonight, and I can give them to you at the end of the meeting. And also, on tonight's agenda was the contract for 214 Soups, and I just wanted to thank the leadership of that union. Worked well with our city staff during negotiations. That's it.
Thank you. The next order of business is public input. Under the rules of the City Commission, each speaker will be allowed to speak for 5 minutes. Commissioner Hilliker will be the timekeeper. This is the opportunity for citizens to address the Commission regarding any agenda item or any other matter. Anyone wishes to address the commission, please come forward and sign the registration. You can name an answer for the record.
Alex, I'm really thinking it's out there. This is going to be something that's different for me. My actual project that I did, kind of on the site here, kind of show. So look up LLC ownership of land lots within the county. Couldn't anyone have something that? This took almost 2 weeks and some help from a couple of people to get done. But there's almost 4,500 lots within the county of Bay County that are owned by just LLCs. Not companies, not limited partnerships, just LLCs flat. Seems like a really high number. I haven't gone to Commissioner Dee Krause's office for the exact number of lots we have in the county, but I'm going to guess about 15,000 to 20,000. Of those 4,500-ish properties, just for you guys' information, the state of Delaware had just did Delaware itself. Seriously. I do that in the right picture. You can also get to that, that's fine. As 264 properties listed to them, a town in Wyoming called Sheridan, which is only about 10,000 people, has 46 properties. Albuquerque, New Mexico has about 20. And it's just kind of strange, like just looking at this from up isn't interesting. As the depth of investment or ownership in the county, there's some LLCs which are generally owned by actual people in the end, not necessarily owned by large companies, which would take a lot more looking into. Shows that, you know, there's a lot of people around here who live in houses or farmland or own businesses that are owned by people who may not live around here, and how much that could be affecting their rent prices, but these prices depending on by arrangement, or the, you know, cell towers, those are separate lots too. So looking at that, it's a very interesting endeavor. And in total, of the ones that are owned in City of Bay City itself, the number is 932 that are owned by LLCs. And Bay City doesn't have a lot of dead land like that. Like you have not in the Elk County where you have farms where there's nobody living on, just a plot of field or a cell phone tower stuck along the road. And it just, fun project, kind of look at, see where these all these were. And, you know, I made a point with this, one of the kids, like, there's a lot of stuff here, and this is all public data. I didn't have to FOIA anything, I didn't have to do anything else, just to look up and see who owns what, where it's coming from, and who knows, this may turn into a, well, let's look at companies, like find companies or partnerships or anything like that, just see how much of it is people who live here and can actually support the community, how much is outside that we're relying on, or is it possibly outside force that are forcing rents up for people or forcing housing prices up. I need not more data to make any sort of
lovely man, great information. I'm here because I was looking for the minutes of the previous years of the approval of the Miller Street Management Board. And I wasn't able to locate them. And our only concern, when I say our, is some of the property owners. We're not looking to pick a fight or anything of the sort. We just want to make sure that the board is running in accordance to the bylaws, which is the Act 120. And the reason we bring that up is, and I think that Jay Sanborn may have sent all you commissioners this, so it's the expiration of the qualifying period, the special meeting to approve the new zone plan. And so it says that approval of the new zone plan at the special meeting should be by more than 60% of the property owners, assessable property voting at that meeting. And we were just concerned that we've never been invited to a meeting, and we're not sure if that is the case, if that is how it works. Speaking with the city assessor, I'm not quite sure if that is how it goes or isn't. If we could, we are just looking for an explanation, whether it's from the city assessor, the city manager, whomever. We don't have an issue with it, we just want a clarification. That's what we're actually looking for. So I appreciate you folks taking the time, and I'm asking you folks to not vote on that approval yet, because we want an understanding of that that's going to be recorded on the budget. We've never, the property owners have not been invited to the special meeting to vote on it. And we thought that we were supposed to. That's where we're at. So we appreciate your time. And on this letter here that was sent to me, and I'm assuming there's 67 other property owners that are in the district, that it was published once in the Bay City Democrat on Wednesday, November 15th. And so we were looking to see where that was at. The Bay City Democrat, we don't believe it's been in operation for like 15 years, but you may want to look at that. That's stated on the bottom of the letter that was sent to all of us. And because of that, we feel we should table this, even if it needs to be published and put in the right publication. And maybe we could have a special meeting with the assessor or somebody, maybe Sarah or whomever, to explain to us if we do need that meeting or if we don't. And I appreciate all your folks' time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Did you know, though, this door that it's in the Lincoln Journal? This is now the newspaper.
I don't have it on there. This is the Bay City Democrat.
The Bay City Democrat has been gone for years.
Kathy, this is not too late.
So anyhow.
I'm sorry.
I got scolded. Thank you. Anyone else who wants to address the commission?
Good evening, everybody. I'm Joel Tacy from 3125 Coventry Drive. December Dazzler was a success. This may have been the very first district-wide promotion in the history of the Midland Street Business District, and I hope there are many more to come. I want to give special thanks to the management board, the Midland Street Management Board, made it possible, all the commissioners as well, the businesses that participated. 10 businesses participated in weekend sales, fun inflatable displays, and of course, we were able to raise funds for the Santa House. That was amazing. And we're working on some extra, future promotions to attract attention to customers in a new way to the Midland Street Business District. Regarding the cost of closing Midland Street for the special events, apparently, and I could be wrong, but apparently the cost is $1,400 that number's been floated around. I don't know where it came from exactly. But if that's the case, it's too high in my opinion. I do understand that workers need to get paid to close the street, but if there's any way to possibly lower that cost, that would be an excellent thing for the district. And the final thing I'd like to mention is the business directory for the Middle Street Business District hasn't been updated for 12 years. It's pretty much useless. And so that's my next project that I'm working on, and my goal is to complete it in January. Middle Street has changed a lot in the last 12 years, but so far I've noted 44 different businesses, with sombreros and lumber barons opening in 2024, which is going to be amazing for the district. This updated directory is a great first step in showing the Great Lakes Bay region all the wonderful shops, eateries, and services that the Middle Street Business District has to offer. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Is there anyone else? Seeing no one, the next order is public hearing. None this evening. Hang on, I'm sorry. I just found it on the bottom of my. Okay, so it is public hearing number one. And it's the resolution for adopting the Midland Street Management Board certified special assessment role. Commissioner Dacker.
Move to allow the public hearing number one, area the adopting the Midland Street Management Board special certification assessment role.
Is there a motion, Commissioner?
I'll second.
Any discussion? So if anyone wants to address the commission regarding the public hearing, please come forward, sign your registration sheet, and state your name and address. Once again, do I have 5 minutes to speak? See no one before. The next order is.
Special order number one, commission as a whole resolution adopting the Midland Street Management Board certified special assessment role, recommendation approved.
Move to approve.
Second.
Thank you. I did get some information just for clarification, just to make sure it's accurate. So Act 120 of 1961 covers both principal shopping districts and business improvement districts. I know we've gotten a lot of information and questions about some of the processes to approve and vote on. So just to clarify, it was Midland Street Business District was set up as a principal shopping district. Can we clarify that?
That's correct. That is 100% correct.
So some of the other citations, about 60%, that applies to the business improvement district. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
I do want to address, though, or hear addressed, there is funds of $120,000 in the Midland Street District. Is it attached to this collection? Did somebody answer that or verify that?
I have to have Sarah come.
So yeah, the $129,000 that you're referring to is their fund balance. So for their special assessment, it can't go anywhere else. It has to stay in that area. So if they don't spend their full budget for the year, it goes into their fund balance, their bank account, whatever you call it. So the $129,000 is just spend money that's accumulated over several years that has not been used.
But they have to stay in the district and it would benefit the whole district to utilize, right? I don't like just creating camps of money just to raise money. Do we feel that, I mean, is there a plan or what is, you know, ultimately, I know there's been some discussions to utilize those funds versus just collect funds.
Correct. So there are some improvements to some of the parking lots that we're looking at doing. Additionally, there is some discussion about potentially doing a light project on the 500 block. So obviously there are some trees that need to be removed for
Commissioner Gerard brought up the fund balance, and I believe, how long has the Midland Street Business District been? 1988, so 35 years, and I think that money's accumulated over the course of 35 years, so it's not just been a couple of years, you know, they have $3,000-$5,000 a year. And they did discuss at the last meeting, like Mrs. Dimitrov said, about cutting some trees down, grades, sidewalk work, light project in the 500 block, also maybe putting some money towards the development of a parking lot near the marina, on the grass in front of the marina. So they do have a plan to start spending some of that money down. And then regarding to what Commissioner Gerard said about the difference between the principal shopping districts and business improvement zones, some of the language in the law is applies to one and not the other. And then a lot of this too, in reading, I read the law more times than I needed to. There was quite a few amendments that were done to this law in the 2023 legislative session. And it says on several of the pages, it says, you know, this section is amended, effective 91 days after adjournment of the 2023 regular session. The 2023 regular session ended on November 14th, so that would put 91 days, like February 15th. Some of these things take effect 2024, so it's not in effect as of right now. And I'm going to support this. I don't recall, since I've been on the commission, that this has ever been challenged the way it has. Simple form, the challenge is coming because there's a small group that wants just to control Midland Street. And they disagree with the board, but from what I've seen, the management board is doing good things and moving the district in a positive direction. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is that meant that there is, I'm still trying to understand what the discrepancy is here, because it seems like not everyone's on the same page with this, and is that meant that we're hearing this here in the meeting? So I need to know what the issue is and why everyone's on the same page with this or with the Midland Street Management Board. I don't understand what's going on, why it seems like some people were not included in voting on this at the local board. I don't know what's happening. I just want to get some clarification on why everyone's on the same page with this.
I can probably shed some light on Sarah can chime in on that. The Midland Street Management Board did vote on it, and it's represented by representatives on Midland Street, so they did vote on the plan coming forward. There was also notices sent to every business owner that's affected by the special assessment, so the information was in that special assessment notice that was sent to them, along with the plan. I believe the plan went out to them as well. So the communication piece was there, and the Midland Street Management Board did vote on this.
Is there a specific reason why people are coming here saying that they did not know about this?
I can't speak for them, Commissioner. The communication piece on the city side existed, and the communication went out very well from our side. And it's been discussed, to be honest, I've been going to the Midland Street Management Board meetings. It's been discussed at many of them. I want to say going back 3, 4, 5 meetings, it's been a discussion item on the agenda. Okay.
Okay, that's all I have.
Thank you. Anyone else? Seeing none, let's call the roll of the motion.
Commissioner Gerard?
Yes.
Wisowski?
Yes.
Clements?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Dockett?
Yes.
Rivet?
Yes.
Ernie?
Yes.
Looker?
Yes.
Yes.
The motion is approved.
Last item is communication number 7, the Midland Street Management Board meeting minutes from January through September 2023. Recommendation received.
Commissioner
Second.
Commissioner Nedzinski?
Yes.
Clements?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Dockett?
Yes.
Trivett?
Sorry.
A motion to receive the minutes.
Yes.
Bernie?
Yes.
Flucker?
Yes.
Jordan?
Yes.
Yes.
The motion is approved. And for the check, end of our business completely, it is, and we are adjourned.